So welcome, everyone. I appreciate everyone hanging on, as I mentioned before, as we were getting started, for those of you that are joining around the world. And welcome to Customer Week. This has been something that I've been very excited to start and very excited to work with everyone here at Ezoic putting together. It's been a lot of labor hours and time and energy put into making sure that we get this right. But at the same time, it's been something that we've been working on in many cases for well over a year. And I'm excited to share with you some of what we've been working on. So for those that don't know me, I am Tyler Bishop. I am our CMO. And I have two Shiba Inus, which are dogs. Many people know them from the Doge meme. So yeah, I had them before they were cool, I guess. I've had them for a long time. I've had one that's 10 years old and then another that's 12. And I'll probably get more in the future. I'm also a black belt in jiu-jitsu. I help host Pubtelligence, which is a event hosted at Google around the world for publishers. It's been a while since we've been able to do one, but I anticipate we'll be able to do one again here sometime soon. And I own over 100 domains, which for many of you joining today, that might be a small number, because I know that any publisher spends some time perusing the internet late nights and you end up with a whole bunch of different domains and ideas that you never really have a chance to start. For me, it's hundreds and I probably couldn't even remember the names of all of them. So why Customer Week? Why are we putting this together? And why is the marketing guy the one that's sharing all of this information? A big part of this is because I'm a firm believer that a product is what creates a business. And I believe that we have a great product. And that means that the best marketing is to ensure that our customers are having good experiences and that we continue to bring more and more customers to use our technology and what we have to offer. And many of you may have seen the announcement recently of our $12.4 million investment in our own customers. And that means all of you joining here today, if you're an Ezoic customer, that you'll have an opportunity to benefit from that directly. And I can go into more detail on that here as we go. But I wanna also introduce everyone to some of the new products and features that we'll be discussing this week for Customer Week. And that's really the point, is we wanted to be able to do everything cohesively. So you'll see today that we have a major expansion of our services and our offering for all of our publishers. But there were a number of things that we wanted to have in place before we brought that forward. And the biggest reason why is because we want everyone to see the benefits of some of the different things that we've been building and putting together for our customers. And one of the things that we want to do with not just this week, but moving forward, and I think you'll find this both throughout our product and the way that we basically support our customers, is celebrating your successes. And the reason for that is I had shared something recently on my personal social media, and it was something that we had shared through our Ezoic channels as well, but it was one of our customers that had a really, really inspiring story. If you go back to the start of the pandemic in March 2020, they were in rough shape. And I think the thing that really stuck out to me is that the story really wasn't ready to be finished yet. And the reason why I said that is because their story wasn't unique. I know a lot of publishers that were disrupted by everything that's happened over the last year and a half, and not only just disrupted, but uncertain. And that's something that we take into account and something that we want to be able to be there and to support and help our customers and be the ones that help them navigate things like this. This is a site that I know the owner well. It's a rodeo-based site. So for those that maybe aren't familiar with the American rodeo scene or what an American rodeo is, it looks a lot like roping cattle and riding bulls and things like that. And so as you can imagine, in March 2020, there were not many rodeos. And you can see over here at the bottom of the screen, the revenue for this publisher, as soon as people stopped searching for the closest rodeos or information on the rodeos, that their business that they depended on, and it wasn't their only site, but many of their sites were very similar, they were in a place of major concern. And 1 year later, and counting, speaking to the owner here recently, they've never been more successful. And you can see that their EPMV and traffic started to return to their pre-pandemic average about exactly a year later. But the really inspiring thing was 3 or 4 months after that, they hit their daily revenue record. And then not even a month later, they made that record their daily average. And that to me is one of the things that motivates both myself and all the people internal to Ezoic to continue to work on our product and find ways to help our customers. And when I asked this publisher exactly what they did, how did they navigate this? How did they find success in this time where things were uncertain and their business, frankly, hadn't been in this rough of shape since they had started? And one of the things that they shared was that they knew that they couldn't control, as many of us learn, there's a lot of things we can't control. And one of the things they couldn't control is basically the demand for information that they hosted on their site. But what they could do was buckle down, focus on creating more content for when it did, and then creating content that people would be looking for, or content that was adjacent to their site niche that they'd be able to tap into and find an audience for, even when maybe there might not be rodeos for a while. And they said that they trusted Ezoic's guidance. They used our tools like Leap, and it helped save them money at a time when they were just trying to cut every cost, every overhead expense that they had. And so they created over 120 new articles. And to date, their EPMV increase since their first day with Ezoic is 174%. And so it's a huge success story. And I love hearing those things. And our goal is so that every Ezoic publisher, small or large, has something similar to share. And that's a big part of Customer Week, is being able to celebrate with you these types of successes, these stories. These are a few more that I really like. And not just because of the testimonial to our product, but you can see the different sizes of the publishers that have been able to benefit from this. And we enormously respect the challenge that publishers have, especially in this time, and we take a lot of pride in being able to help them with it. But it really begged the question for us of how can we better help our publishers, both how do we help them know what to do. We know that this is a challenge, especially independent publishers that are starting. And then even the larger publishers that you start employing more and more people, and you ask, what expertise do I need? What variables am I missing? How can I grow faster? And that makes us think, how can we show them how to do things that put them on the right track? We have tens of thousands of websites and tens of thousands of success stories. What information can we glean from that to help all of us? And realistically, help and information and data is great, but it would be great if someone could help you take action, give you direction, get you started, give you the resources that you need to actually complete these things, so that you're not, taking on these huge expenses and being able to, hope that you grow in the next 4 to 5 months. And that was really the motivation behind these announcements that we made last week. And something that's been in the works for quite a while. You may have seen it. I know that I saw it in a lot of different places, but we are going to be investing $12.4 million directly in our customers. And one of the things that I had said in an interview last week when asked about it was, I hate when organizations say that they're investing X amount, millions of dollars in their customers, but what they really mean is that's the salaries that they're paying their engineers to build new products. That's not what this is. This is, in one shape or another, money that is going to be directly put into our customers to either cut your costs or give you a direct cash investment of some kind so that you can grow your site, grow your business. And you'll see that we've actually kind of started this in many ways. So some of our publishers on today's call will have already directly benefited. That's a quote from one of our publishers that we've helped quite considerably as a part of some of our initiatives in Ezoic VIP, which I'll be sharing a little bit more about here in a moment. But a lot of that money is going to be in the form of us being able to take on expenses and costs that you incur. Being able to provide direct cash infusions in the form of grants or investments. And one of the things that I think sticks with me with this is that you're going to find in many of the things that we're announcing today and throughout the week that we'll be guaranteeing the revenue that Ezoic is able to help you generate. And the reason for that is because not only do we want to invest in your business, but we want you to be able to focus on the things that matter most without having to worry about these types of things. And we know that it's something that takes up a space in the minds of many publishers. And it's something that we have an enormous amount of experience and understanding of. And it's something that we would love to be able to continue to help our publishers navigate and putting their best interests at the forefront of that. And the motivation really stems from something that I found to be a constant since we started the business. And that is that our publishers in surveys or in questions that we've asked, one of the things that I always hear is, if I can get help and I can grow, Ezoic grows too. It there's a mutual benefit there. And so I was asked last week, what is the motivation? Like, what is the hope, or what is the catch with the grants and the investments in the customers? And our motivation is exactly this: if you grow, we all grow. And I love Anita's comment here because that's exactly what we want to be. We want to be both the provider of your technology, but also a true partner. And so we are trying to get more of these types of stories. I love to hear them. I share them with everyone internally. It's a bright spot for us. And we'd love for you as a part of Customer Week to share your successes with us and use the hashtag Ezoic Customer Week. And by doing so, you'll be entered in a chance to win one of these pretty cool backpacks. They're good quality backpacks. So if you're like, I don't really need another backpack, or maybe you're like, I really want one, it's a good one. So it's totally worth it. But even if you don't want a backpack, we'd love to hear your story. So that contest is live this morning or evening, depending where you're at. So we'd love to hear from you. But we're only just getting started. And this broadcast today, I know it's going to feel long, and I'm going to take as many questions as I can at the end without dragging things out. But I want to point out that at ezoic.com/customerweek, you can actually follow along all week long, because every day we'll be having various announcements that we think are relevant and important and things that will benefit you. And if you don't want to listen to the recording, or you don't want to watch a webinar every day, that's okay. We are summarizing these things into blogs, tutorials, documentation, summary videos, you name it. There's a lot of things that we'll have available, and you can actually sign up and we'll send them to you directly whenever we publish them each day. So I do encourage that as a resource. And there'll be other times later this week that I've opened myself up and other members of the staff for questions and things like that. Which really leads me to today's headline announcement. We can't have Customer Week and have new features and products and expanded services without trying to put one of the largest ones up front. And it really stems from those questions that I said that we were asking ourselves about how do we show publishers what to do? What can they do to grow, and how do they do it? And today, both the investments that I mentioned and a lot of the other expansion of the way that we offer our products and service to all of our customers is basically the framework that we see as being a way of doing this. And that's why today we're introducing and launching Levels. And so these are live now inside of your Ezoic dashboard. It's been a long effort and one that we've held off on for a long period of time. And I'll kind of go through some of the reasons why in a moment. But if you go into your Ezoic dashboard, where you are able to log in. It's where you would find all your earnings information and control all the different technologies you're using from Ezoic on your site. If you log into your account, you'll see that you have a level, and you'll also find that there's a black widget up in the top corner of your main dashboard. And this will allow you to access both what we're calling the levels dashboard, which is a central place that'll have a lot of the different elements of the things that we're talking about today, alongside the support, help, and expert resources that are available at all the various levels throughout Ezoic. And this is something that we wanted to position together. A lot of these things were separate, and we tried to figure out how do we make them cohesive and helpful for our publishers. So the motivation really is, as a part of Customer Week and the expansion of being able to provide levels, is to really give more to all of our customers. In many cases, we kept finding that our customers didn't actually know all the different things that we provided to them, both from a service, support, technology, and even more. I think with the grants, you're going to see, like, there's a lot that we offer. And if there's anything that I think we do a poor job of at times, it's being able to communicate exactly how much value that we can provide different customers, but we're not always able to really communicate that in a way that everyone can take advantage. So the point of levels in many cases is to create more transparent benefits and benchmarks so that our customers know that as they grow, there's ways that we can further help. And this means expanding the services and the support that we offer as well. I think a lot of publishers don't understand that, you know, as they grow, many of our larger customers were able to provide additional expertise, resources, and consulting for that has a tremendous benefit. And this has really been built so that we can objectively help sites grow faster. The point of everything that we want to do is to make it easier for you to communicate your goals and then act on them and be able to get the right direction and take the right actions. So this is a little bit more information of sort of how we've kind of segmented the various levels. And these all have very, very carefully thought out, sort of thresholds at each level. And the reason for that is because these are the areas where we can start to provide additional things that we've found to help sites that are this size or a cohort of this size to grow. These additional resources have a point of diminishing return in some respects, unless you reach certain levels or thresholds. And so that's really the motivation that we have here, and to make sure that the customers that have taken the time to use Ezoic and grow with Ezoic, sometimes for years and starting from scratch, that we're able to continue to support and help these publishers more and more as they grow. And you'll see below that every level of publisher is able to secure some form or fashion of grant. All of them are eligible for various types of Ezoic monetization. So there's nothing here that we are going to be taking away. In fact, we're going to be adding so much more to all of our publishers, regardless of what level they're at. And you'll notice that there were two numbers on the chart. I'll go back really quickly. When you see starting at level two, there's a green number for visits and a green number for revenue. And then a gray one. And that's because the green numbers are for Ezoic customers. We knew that we wanted to give precedent to those that have taken the time to grow with us over the years. And that starts with Customer Week. We have a promotion going on right now where anyone with an active Ezoic account prior to September 17th, so that's Friday, the end of this week, will be able to progress and achieve levels as an Ezoic customer. So those thresholds, those green numbers, that's the number to hit objectively so that you can reach the next level inside of your Ezoic account. If after September 17th, you haven't had an active Ezoic account, after 3 months of having an Ezoic account active, you'll be subject to Ezoic customer levels. So you create a new account, you start using Ezoic for 3+ months, and you're ready for level two at Ezoic customer levels, you get there. And so if you aren't using Ezoic today, or you've got an Ezoic account, but it's not active, I think there's no better time to get that thing going again. We'd love to help you do it. And I think it's a really important opportunity from the standpoint of this time of year and just the environment that we're in, especially with our revenue guarantee. I can't imagine that there's not a better time to try to take advantage of that. And so that's the reason why we've been really prioritizing this as customer week, is because we see it as a mechanism to bring back customers that maybe have left in the past, but at the same time, wanting to show all of our existing customers that there's a deep love inside of our business for what we do, and we sincerely love helping all of our customers, and this is one of the ways that we wanted to be able to support that sort of like reciprocity, that loyalty, is by being able to lower the threshold for our existing customers. So what are the benefits? Everybody gets more. What does that mean? The benefits of moving up various levels, and you can find all this information at levels.ezoic.com. I've got a lot of that on some slides here to come, but the benefits of moving up levels. Number one, every level, starting at level one, we are guaranteeing that inside of this level that we're providing monetization resources that, and ad partners, you name it, that will allow you to reach the highest revenue that your site is capable of inside of your respective level. And we're willing to guarantee that. And if we can't do it, we'll pay an additional 25%. That's how confident we are in what we're being able to provide our customers. And one of the reasons for levels is so that we can show our publishers that as they grow, that we're able to enable additional ad partners, solutions, put additional resources internally to work for them that maybe we couldn't at lower traffic and revenue levels, simply because those things just aren't available to us to provide. And so that's one of the reasons why we've included both traffic and revenue as thresholds for our customers, is because we want to try to make it as easy to understand as possible. I hate exclusivity, and I like being able to know where the goalposts are, and that's what we wanted to be able to provide to our customers. So you'll find that there are additional monetization partners and solutions and resources available at each level as you ascend and grow, and you'll find that we provide more and more dedicated support and help. So starting in level two, you'll find that you have dedicated success managers, onboarding specialists. And as you progress level three, four, and VIP, we're able to provide experts. In many cases, we have internal SEO, ad ops, developers, engineers, people that can actually help you circumvent some of the costs that you may have investing in third parties or even hiring people, because we have these resources internally that can help and support you. And kind of continuing on that thread, the reason for this is because we see the challenge of growing, where you don't know if you should hire somebody or if you should hire a third party. And ultimately, publishers themselves are the ones that have their own best interests in mind. And the more people that are aligned with your interests working on your behalf, the better. And that's exactly what we want to try to be, is be a resource, a platform, someone that can always be allowing you to understand transparently how different things might be affecting your sites, your growth. And we believe that means giving you the ability to eliminate third parties or be able to understand things for yourself so that you don't have to rely on someone else. And that means in many cases, us being able to support you in that directly through our staff and personnel. And then being able to give more transparency to things like premium, which I personally see a lot of questions about often. How do you get access to premium, which is our ability to provide directly sold advertising deals. Our ad sales team, we have a staff here that actually works with brand advertisers and does direct deals for specific sites, VIP discounts on things like premium and more, and just trying to provide sort of a framework to understand when those things are available and why. So I mentioned every customer will get more today. And the reason why we've taken our time in pushing this out is because I really wasn't happy with us being able to provide this and all of us internally to start to segment our business without being able to have something like Access Now in place. I really like having a threshold below 10,000 visits that allows publishers who are just starting, or maybe even career publishers that are starting a new venture, to have the resources that we provide, and not just monetization, but things like tag tester, video, big data analytics. If I start a new site tomorrow, you better believe that I'm going to use big data analytics to understand the value of different types of content and what type of content I'm creating and how is it engaging my audience. We also wanted to be able to bring on board additional experts and support personnel to start providing the sort of help and support that we knew that it would take to provide this to our customers. And we wanted to be able to give new products and features alongside this stuff so that people could really understand just how much we want to provide as a technology provider and not just a service provider. So you'll see throughout this week, there's new features and products that are available for free, like Leap, that we think are gold standards for what they are. In many cases, these are tools. I think we found with Leap, on average, publishers that were able to remove paid plugins were saving on average $400 to $500 a month, or maybe it was a year. It might have been a year. Don't let the marketing guy give you all the stats. To give real benchmarks and metrics to strive toward, that's really something that we wanted to be able to do with being able to understand what gets you into one level versus another. Like I said before, being able to give transparency to what are the goals and be able to celebrate those things somehow were really important to me, because I think a lot of times, you know, being a publisher is a slog. You create a lot of content for very little reward or very little positive feedback for a long period of time in many cases. And we wanted to be able to kind of help you see that progress, even whenever it doesn't necessarily feel apparent. And then we also wanted to be able to have resources and programs ready to roll in place so that if you're a publisher and you look at something at a higher level and you go, I want that, I think that that's what I need. We wanted to be able to have a system in place that would help you get there faster than you could have on your own. And so if you go into your levels dashboard now, you'll see something that looks a lot like this. You'll have your level. We look at levels and we look at your revenue and visits based on the previous month. So if in August you were really close and both visits and revenue, and you are on pace over the last 30 days to exceed those things, it won't record until we reach the month of September or October, whatever the next month is, and we have that accrued. So that's what we're looking at to sort of level publishers. And then you'll be able to see the progress bar there. If you hover over it in your dash, you'll be able to kind of see where your progress is at and how close you are at various levels. You'll also be able to start recognizing the support system and the people that are available to help. So if you have a dedicated success manager or a team or someone that can help you, you'll have mechanisms to directly reach out to those people. And then also this helps us organize better where particular types of questions or help can be directed. So in many cases, you may need an instant answers, which, and if it's something related to a problem or an issue, we would want you to go to support where we can provide almost an instant response in many cases. But if it's something more strategic to your business, that's something that you might want to go to your publisher success manager for. And so being able to kind of channel those things and also provide access to our new support community, which is launching today as well, you'll start to see that we're providing more and more channels for you to go and find the answers that you're looking for faster. And in addition to that, you'll notice the area where it says join next class. And the reason for that is we've launched Level Up Learning. So Level Up Learning is a completely optional program. I could not emphasize more that it matters not to me if any publisher decides to participate or to not participate. the sole purpose of this program is for your benefit. And if you join and you don't like it, that's fine. If you decide not to join because you think you won't like it, that's fine too. But I will say that we've put considerable resources into making sure that this is something that if you go through and you genuinely give it your best effort in terms of participation, whatever amount of time that you have to dedicate to it, these are one month long sprints, essentially, where throughout a week inside of a community, we'll provide direction, we'll provide examples. And not only that, most of what you'll find is actually run by other Ezoic publishers that have been successful, publishers that I know that we've worked with for years in many cases, that have grown considerably, that know what they're doing and can share specific strategies that they've employed, ways that they've used Ezoic products and services to help them get there faster, so that you can actually learn from each other. And I find all the time that as much as I think I might know about something, I'm always learning from our customers. And so I wanted to create that experience for everyone else as well. And level up learning, I think, really taps into that. So you can actually go into your levels dashboard. If you're level one and up, you can click on join next class. Our next class starts at the start of October. And then you'll be able to join a community. There'll be communication that comes to you in your dashboard and through email that'll help you ensure that you don't miss out on anything there. But there'll be opportunities for grants and other things like that that will be exclusive to this program. So I mentioned, you know, why would you want to join? It's pretty simple. You join the next class. There's going to be weekly tasks and sessions you can attend. Again, you can do as much or as little as you like. You'll be able to engage with others and have real-time conversations with some of those that are leading these sessions. So you can get, you know, advice or ask them questions about specific things that they've done. And at the end of each week, we're going to open up new opportunities to earn things like grants. So you'll be able to actually physically apply for money that we will give you to grow as a part of this. And the idea is that we will be providing this because we think that the publishers that are doing these things, engaging these activities, are going to grow. And we think that, you know, cash in many cases can help with things like content production or additional things that might be able to help you grow faster, reduce your overhead costs. If this isn't your full-time gig, maybe it can be. And these are the different types of grants and funding. Speaking of the grants, there's really three that we sort of look at: Spark, Growth, and Incubator. Spark grants are available to all customers. And these are really small cash grants. There's very few strings attached, meaning it's not like we're going to lock you into some kind of rigid agreement. This really is something where we believe in our publishers. And it's something where if a small amount of money in many cases can help you continue to grow or reinvest in things like content or something like that, couple hundred dollars, couple thousand dollars. These are things that we think can help publishers grow faster. Growth grants are a little bit larger investments that are only available to level 2 through 4 and VIP customers. And there is a little bit more specific criteria that we're looking for, but it's really, we want publishers that are growing. So if you're growing your traffic and your revenue month over month consistently when using Ezoic, you're a great target for one of these grants. These are not ones that you have to participate in any type of program for, like a Spark grant. These are grants that we will be targeting for specific publishers that are doing all the right things and seemingly growing very quickly. And then our incubator investments are much larger investments. There are a few additional terms and conditions for these because they are quite a bit larger, but they really are an investment made in a small amount of publishers that will be opening these applications up for publishers level 3 and up, where if you're an independent publisher that maybe is considering your first couple like actual employee hires, or you want to hire additional people, or maybe you want to make this your full-time job and maybe it's not today, that's the point of these types of investments, is to really give you the capital to make those types of significant moves. And this gives you a little bit of a framework for sort of how we will be kind of I guess, positioning some of the different grants and what's available for each of them. So you can see that every publisher, regardless of level, has opportunities here. And again, I know that there's probably a decent amount of questions both about the levels and the grants, and I'll kind of point you towards some resources there towards the end. And then I'll also try to hop into the chat and answer a few questions before we're finished. And speaking of the growth grants, if you are a level two, or I believe, level two through four and VIP publisher, we're actually going to be contacting select growth grant eligible recipients this week. So watch your inbox if you qualify. If you are growing quickly and you've been an Ezoic customer for a minute, you are potentially a target. And so we'll reach out to you this week and provide an application if you're eligible. And we look forward to divvying out some of those growth grants and telling those stories here shortly. Ensure that that Ezoic emails don't go to spam or other folders, and then follow any customer week and Ezoic announcements to ensure you don't miss out if we have additional opportunities for things like this week. This is a sort of an animated look at the levels dashboard. So you'll notice here there is a survey that we would like to get information from you from, mainly because as you continue to progress and grow with Ezoic, we want to celebrate. We may want to send you things and help just recognize the accomplishments that you've had with Ezoic. You'll notice that there is the ability to apply and to access the next level once you get there up the top. We also have an achievement section down here now. We've identified specific metrics that are associated with our publishers that are growing the fastest. And we want you to see what those are. And we want to celebrate those with you as you hit them. And so we think that this makes it a little bit more fun to continue to work on your site and do the types of things that we know are associated with growing and being able to get to additional levels where more resources might be available. So I mentioned all the questions and, I don't profess to say, even if I would have spent the entire webinar today on all the different questions and things like that I'm sure will surface. We've done a good job of creating a FAQ section here on levels.ezoic.com. Everything from information about the Level Up program to the grants to what is in the different monetization levels in terms of ad partnerships and solutions and things like that. All the way down to how the grants work and exactly how the levels work. So you can probably imagine all kinds of crazy scenarios and things like that. Can you level up quicker? Can you level down? Like all kinds of questions about that. They're all in the levels.ezoic.com site. So you can go over there to more information. There's the FAQ with lots of questions that are answered there. And more information about the revenue guarantee, the grants, you name it. And we've embedded comment sections on many of these pages as well. So if you have a question that's not answered in there, we'll actually publish it and then we'll answer it so that way any questions that collectively are asked, everyone can kind of scroll down and read through the answers. So I wanted to get ahead of some of the ones that I asked lots and lots of our publishers ahead of time what kinds of questions they had from this. And these were the ones that were the ones that popped up. So I figured I would at least address them on here. It might save everyone some reading time. So how are the visits and revenue calculated for each level? I kind of mentioned this earlier, but we're looking at the previous month's total visits and total revenue from all the sites active within your account. So this isn't just taking your largest site. If you're a level one publisher and maybe you've got a big site that's not currently live with Ezoic, if you bring that into your Ezoic account, we'll total the cumulative number of all the visits and revenue, and you'll be able to level up if the total is matches a higher level threshold. So if you're creating a new account and adding a site for the first time, we'll automatically base the estimate from 30-party databases. Like, well, there's a handful that we use, but we'll be looking at the past 30 days to try to put you in the right level. And as you accrue data inside of Ezoic, we'll look at that information and make sure that you're in the right level. Will a site earn more revenue at higher levels? The answer is yes, we guarantee it. And not just more money, but the most. This was something I was really adamant about because I've found over and over again that sites start using our technology, and then as they grow, they'll often leave and have a third party that will implement, in many cases, the exact sorts of ad demand and ad solutions that Ezoic gave them control over. And now they're forced into a contract. They're forced to spend a significant amount of their revenue just to pay for these types of services, and in many cases that provide far worse user experience. And that's something that we wanted to be able to help our publishers take back control of. Whether you want to know everything about how your site is making money, or you could care less about the technical inner workings, we think it's always in your best interest to have that control. And that's one of the reasons why we've decided to make it a little bit more transparent about what types of solutions are available at each level. How do publishers know what level their site is in? It should be in your levels dashboard. If for any reason you've got an error there, or you're not able to see it properly, you can let support know. And I would say this as well, bear with us as we've rolled this out all out today. We've done a lot of beta testing and spot checking, but as we sort of progress through this, I'm sure that there'll be edge cases in which we need to correct something for a site. We've worked really hard to make sure that there's only a benefit here. So if you're afraid that you're missing out on something, don't worry. We've kind of assembled things on the back end so that all publishers are insured to benefit from this. And if you want to know how do you move up to the next level, or you think you might be on the cusp or ready now, that's one of the reasons why we wanted to give people the ability to apply to the next level. Even if you don't meet those traffic thresholds yet, there's always a nuanced situation or edge case in which it might make sense. You might be bringing a new site on. Maybe your traffic has exponentially grown in the last few weeks because you ranked number one for a popular trending topic or something. And there would be ways that we could potentially help publishers move quicker. And then additionally, maybe there's something that we're missing, and we'd certainly want to correct that. But one of the things that is a constant here is because of the way that we set up both our partners and then also assemble different resources like experts and things like that to support you, we want to make sure that everyone is able to get the best experience possible when they move to the next level. And so for that reason, no matter what, once you hit level one, you'll have to apply to the next level. We will notify you if you qualify. So if you haven't applied to the next level and you've reached it, we'll let you know it's time to apply. And we'll certainly move quickly if that's the case. And not only that, I want to mention as well, if you're an Access Now publisher, there will be no need for an application. Once we detect that the previous month's traffic and revenue hit the threshold for level one, we'll automatically move you to level one. And we think that that's a huge accomplishment, and one definitely worth celebrating. To that point, I'm one step ahead of myself. If the site is in Access Now, they'll be graduate weighted to level one automatically. If you are assigned to the wrong level, you can use the resources inside of your levels dashboard or apply to the higher level and provide some details. The more details, the better. That's one of the reasons why we just created an open box there, so that it makes it easy for you to explain something that might not be easily categorized in a drop-down menu or something like that. And so that's the end. I knew that this would feel kind of long, to be honest. It went a little bit faster than I thought it would, mainly just because if any of you had the chance to visit one of our events or attend any of our webinars, I'm a little bit more long-winded than most. And so I appreciate everyone sticking on here if some of the things were apparent, and maybe over-explain them, but I want to make sure that everyone understands exactly how much we've thought about how we can support and help all of you and the many more of you to come. And that's the motivation behind everything we'll be announcing for Customer Week. And this is just day one. So if you have questions, if you want to review some of this, if you were like, I was barely paying attention, I had this thing open in another window, that's fine. You can read recaps, you can access the slides, the recordings, and even more info about each day's announcements and how to get the most out of it, where to find things. There'll be features that maybe you want to learn how to use them or get the most out of them. You'll be able to get that at zoic.com/customer week. And as I mentioned before, you can actually sign up and we'll send you the drops of all the stuff that we launch each day. So yeah, we won't spam you, just trying to let you know about everything that's available. And to get any answers about levels, level up learning, grants, I strongly encourage you to visit levels.ezoic.com. All that information is in there. We've spent a lot of time talking to many of you before this so that we could really anticipate many of the types of questions that we would get. And so much of the information is in there. I want to take this chance because I mentioned at the beginning, but the Share Your Success contest is live. So hashtag Ezoic Customer Week, have a chance to win a backpack. I personally will go through and read all of them. I really enjoy it. I set time aside each week to try to find those types of stories and share them with everyone internally. And there's more to come. So I will try to take a few questions out of both the Q&A or the chat as I see them. Bear with me. I see there's a lot of messages in the chat. I don't know how many of those are questions in the Q&A. It's a little bit more manageable. So I'll stay on here for about another 5 to 10 minutes. But I know that some of this will be something that many of you are either watching the recording or going into the Customer Week area and kind of reading a little bit more about. Later this week, the Ezoic Publishers Group, which is a Facebook group that I know a lot of our customers are in. They've asked me to do a Q&A. It's a 24-hour Q&A, so it's not instant, but you can ask questions in there and I'll get in there and answer along with other members of the staff starting on Wednesday. And then on Friday, I'll be doing a final webinar wrap-up that will be largely geared towards taking questions. So that webinar will be far less me talking and far more me answering questions. So I'm going to stop sharing my screen and let's see what I can find here in the Q&A. So Stuart asks, what is the difference from publishers added from premium and those added from the A+ and A++ ad partners? So the biggest difference is the ad networks, ad exchanges, and some of the ad partners. So premium is directly sold advertising deals that we can sell across. So we might be able to get a brand that wants X amount of impressions of certain types of traffic, and we can provide that to them through our cohort of customers. And so that's why with premium, we invite publishers that that fit a bill to where we can actually run those campaigns with them, and we're adding to those all the time. And so we hope to continue to be able to offer more and more premium to publishers that can have it now. A+ and A++ are including more networks, header bidders, exchanges that really do have thresholds for the types of traffic that they'll work with. So the site doesn't have a certain number of visits or page views, that particular ad network may not be able to work with them, even if they are operating as a child account to Ezoic. So the difference there really is just what additional solutions and partners we're able to turn on or enable or whitelist your website for. Are these grants like an interest-free loan that we have to return back, or just funding with or without equity, or like a scholarship? The answer is these grants are just cash, not an interest-free loan. In most cases, it's just us literally saying, you're growing, this is what the money is for. You'd have to agree that you say you're going to spend the money on content or something to invest in your website. But like I said, we're not going to tie into it too deep of a degree. As we get into the incubator investments and things like that, there may be a little bit more involved there in terms of being able to have a relationship or some kind of contract with Ezoic. especially if we're giving, you know, 50, 60 grand or something like that in many cases. But yeah, I think all those things will make sense. I would imagine that if anyone was to look at sort of the terms that we have for these, they'd be very pleasantly surprised. But yeah, most of the growth and Spark grants have very few strings attached. It's very much like a cash grant. Another question about the grants. And then also, can you de-level if you sell one of your sites or the traffic goes down? Yes. So you can go down a level, and here's the criteria for that. You can read more about it on the level site, but if your site is, let's say, level two, and you just happen to have one of your sites start getting less traffic. Maybe it was really getting a lot of traffic during the holiday season and now it's not. We'll notify you that your traffic has started to decrease and that you will be moved down a level, but we'll give you 12 months to ensure that you meet the level two threshold again before you're de-leveled. However, the exception is if a site is removed. If you're removing a site, and that's the reason why your traffic or revenue has fallen below the level threshold, you have 30 days. So you can add the site back, you can get the other sites to meet the criteria, or you can add a different site if it helps get you there. But as long as you're not removing a site, you'll have up to 12 months to try to get your traffic and revenue back to where it was at to stay in the level that you're at. Otherwise, it'll be 30 days if a site is removed. This publisher says, I am level three. I reached the earnings goal for level four, but not the visits goal. This is because of a high EPMV. Am I eligible for level four? The answer is we've included both traffic and revenue for situations like this. Largely the reverse, because there are sites out there that just because of the type of traffic or audience or topic, they may not earn as high of an EPMV as others. And so being able to marry those things together actually gives us more clear guidelines in terms of both the ad partners and the resources that we physically can and can't provide to some publishers. So that makes us a lot easier to provide different things that we maybe couldn't to publishers if they had a really high EPMV or a really low one, but the traffic maybe didn't align with their revenue. So the answer is, you know, it kind of requires both, but there is the ability to apply, and you might be able to provide some additional color or details in your application that would allow one of our team members to review it and make an exception in some cases. So someone else asking about the core advertisers versus A++, along those lines, that the basically the different types of ad partners available for different levels. This is on the levels site, but I'll kind of go over it briefly. So our core advertisers that are available to everyone are access to Google's Ad Exchange. For those that aren't familiar, Google has two primary ad products. One is AdSense, which you can link through mediation if you have an AdSense account. I strongly encourage you to do so. It only allows competition. You know, you allow Ezoic to let the money roll freely into that account, and you don't touch any of it. And then in addition, it can drive up the bids of other advertisers. Anyways, Ad Exchange is Google's larger sort of Wall Street trading floor where all ad networks bid. And it's not largely available to most publishers on their own, but through us, a Google certified publishing partner, they do get access to it. So all of our customers have access to Google's Ad Exchange, popular header bidders that we're able to have a parent account for, that we can make all of our sites child accounts for, and some other popular ad exchanges that they compete with Google, maybe not to the same degree or have the same market dominance that they do, but again, adding a lot of value there. And so all of our customers have access to that core cohort of advertisers. A++, this is whenever we're able to start to open up additional header bidders, Amazon A9, some of these other types of things. We do, as you get into the higher levels, we can start testing in like various e-commerce based solutions. I won't profess to be the the leading expert on the most cutting edge or the stuff that's out there or hot in the industry right now for ad ops. But I do know that there's always a number of partners that are can definitely contribute to revenue in some cases, significant ways. And the different kind of segments that we have sort of align with when we're able to enable those. Access Now has grayed out items, but no way to change. If it's something is grayed out, it's because it's not available at that yet. Many of the things that we've provided for the levels really don't start until level one. And the reason is because Access Now is really meant to help sites get started, give them access to data, be able to actually earn some revenue from their efforts so that they can realize that they're on the right track, or maybe even cater some of the ways that they create content towards, you know, being able to generate a profit. But we really want to emphasize that when you're in Access Now, you should be focused on creating content and growing your site. And we want to support you in being able to do that. But many of the other things that maybe we provide or have as a program is really for the sites that have sort of kind of reached that threshold and maybe are now starting to figure out, okay, now what direction should I take with my business? Answer the question about being downgraded. Spark grants are only available inside of Access Now. I believe there's a mechanism now that once you complete the certifications and things along those lines, that there's an opportunity to do that. And then the other ones are only available inside of the Level Up program, which won't start until October. Once we achieve a level and it drops, yep, ask that one. Yeah, so for those that are looking to grow Access Now, really many of the onboarding resources that we provide, we think help publishers get the right start. We also have our weekly webinars that are available from our team that focus on everything from, you know, getting the most out of Ezoic technology to actually doing things like social media marketing and things like that. So I would say the resources to look towards if you are an Access Now publisher and you're not able to get into Level Up Learning yet is to attend the regular webinars for that are provided through Ezoic twice a week from our publisher success team. And additionally, the Ezoic blog, I think, and YouTube channel are really great resources for learning to do all kinds of different things. And in addition, I can say that I'll share that we are investing internally in more and more educational resources that we plan to make available for free for our customers. Thanks, Joanna. I appreciate the comment. I can't wait to meet you again either. And if you don't have access to levels or you're not seeing it in your dashboard, just create a ticket to support. I can say that in most cases, I think we've rolled it out to everybody, but there's, like I said, it came out today. So I'm sure that there could be a reason or something specific that we could look at and get that situated for you. I answered the question about the differences between levels and revenue. Someone said, as a premium member who has been assigned to level one, it would appear I'm losing access to my publisher success manager. How would this only benefit me if I'm losing access to things? Actually, that's one of the biggest reasons why we have created this, is because in many cases, people didn't have access to an actual dedicated support manager. And through the process of either onboarding or messaging with someone in support, they were often talking to a team member that maybe wasn't even assigned to them. And that meant that people were not getting quick answers. They were not getting good answers in many cases to their questions. And so this allows us to actually show externally and provide the right channels to everyone, regardless of whether or not they have a dedicated publisher success manager or not. One of the things that we said universally before launching this, because it kept coming up internally in discussions, was, you know, this doesn't change anything in terms of we have to provide great support and support channels and resources. So you'll see that we've launched a new support community along with many other things this week. And so I would imagine that anything that you've used a publisher success manager or someone that you've communicated with Ezoic for, that you would find that your service and support would be much better now, regardless of whether or not you were communicating with somebody directly before or not. I think the situation will be better now. Someone asking if when can they see the whole Ezoic team in one picture video, or team behind Ezoic video will be awesome. I know many of the team members are probably watching or listening throughout the office right now. I almost, and this is me probably being bolder than I should. I almost told members of my team here that if they wanted to, they could just come in at the end. But I thought that that might just be craziness. But one of the things that I think everyone will find here shortly is that throughout the week, we will have actually some of our engineers talking about some of the products that they've built and highlighting why they think that they offer tremendous value or benefit to our publishers. And so, in fact, in many cases, I'm the one communicating, but I'm probably the least equipped to answer many of the questions and go through some of the things that we offer, because there really are a great team behind everything here at Ezoic. Do you guys get advertisers from ad exchanges or directly, like other websites have separate dashboard for advertisers where they can get targets and stuff? So I'm not exactly sure about the question, but I do know that we do offer. I didn't know if somebody was trying to take me up on my offer or not, but one of the things that we will be broadcasting is a part of like highlighting the different solutions from a monetization standpoint that are available to all publishers at various levels, is that we'll be starting to show the different types of ad exchanges and advertisers that we are whitelisting as you move up levels. We don't have this now, but we plan to show it in the future, because we think it's good to know, mainly because I think of ad demand as a commodity, and it's really our technology, the machine learning, that is what enables our customers, in many cases, have been using us for 5-6 years to continually grow their EPMV. Because if you show every visitor the exact same ad placements, ad sizes, ad locations, you fundamentally are going to make less money and provide a worse user experience, regardless of what you think it looks like. That's the truth. That's objective. And that's where our technology really comes into play. And we think that focusing on the ad demand side, where the ads are coming from, is one of the things that is the most distracting. And so we want to be able to highlight for customers all the different things that we're providing on that side, so that it's not something that worries them or is something they have to be concerned about. And that's the other reason for the guarantee. We do have the technology now for many of our publishers in VIP, where advertisers can actually hit a special landing page on their site and buy direct campaigns from them that will start running instantly through Ezoic. They're high earning campaigns that they're able to have brands directly buy from them programmatically. I answered the question about how we're measuring and tracking revenue and visits. It's the previous month. And it's traffic and revenue that goes through Ezoic. So if you're split testing and you're running, 10% of your traffic through, non-Ezoic, we'll be looking at your visits and revenue accrued on the Ezoic platform. If you can't see the levels in your dashboard and you cleared the cache, what's the next step? You can reach out to support. One thing I will mention is that our German and French language markets actually have sort of unique products in their own right, because many of the ad partners, solutions, and many of the things that we provide them in terms of dedicated staff and things like that, because we have dedicated teams in those markets that provide something quite a bit different, we haven't launched levels for all of our French, German, and Spanish speaking publishers, but we plan to in the future. It'll probably look a little bit different, just because, like I said, some of the things operate differently in those markets, don't necessarily align with levels the way that they are in most of the other global markets. But that was partially done because we we actually think that in many cases, sites would get less in those markets if we were to implement levels as we have it today. So that's the only other reason I can think of is somebody might not have some of that, but you can create a support ticket if you're still not seeing anything. I kind of spoke to the level threshold, previous month's revenue, 30 days. So on the levels.ezoic site, kind of highlights a little bit more about premium. So premium is only available from waitlist, I believe, in level one, and then level two, three, and four. I think there's other caveats and things like that, but we also give some direction on basically what should you aim for. Premium is not something that we provide or don't provide because we want to or feel like it. It's really whenever we can help you tap into an ad campaign or brand ad campaign that we've helped create. And if we can't, and we can't guarantee that you would make more money from having premium, we don't offer it. And so whenever we do offer it, it's because we know with relative certainty that it will make you more money. The grants question about how many grants are available per level, how much, that's all on the grants page of levels.ezoic. It's not all concrete in my memory, but there's a max amount and per level. Once you reach another level, it sort of resets. There's a max amount, another level. And the max amount doesn't mean that's how much you would get per grant. You might get three grants, but over the course of those three grants, you couldn't go over the max, that sort of thing. And let's see, I'm almost to the end here. So I'm going to take these last three and then I'm going to cut it off. So if someone just asking if they're in the right level, I would say just, yeah, bear with it a few days. It's traffic and revenue. So if you have a lot of visitors, but the revenue isn't there for the previous month, maybe in September, you'll hit those thresholds. But you can always apply to the next level and things like that. But there's some more detailed answers to that to look through on levels.ezoic if you have more questions. How much will EPMV increase after you get to another level? It's the same as me just trying to guess off the top of my head what your EPMV is. I always tell people it's between $1 and $1,000 because EPMVs vary dramatically. I know three sites off the top of my head that one makes a $10 EPMV, another one makes a $20 EPMV, and another one makes a $45 one. And they, on the surface, look like they're the exact same type of site. They all talk about the exact same topic. They all have largely US visitors. And the difference really is their content. Some of them answer questions about tutorials, one's on news, and then the other one is kind of on how to do stuff. And the EPMVs are wildly different. So to guess exactly what a percentage increase would be, from level to level is really, really hard, but it will increase. It just depends. How many accounts does a published success manager handle on average? Just curious. It's a good question. It varies. We've been expanding those teams, and so less and less all the time. To be honest with you, I don't know that I could answer that question offhand. We have members of the team on later this week that might be able to give you a better idea. But yeah, I would say once you get into level four and VIP, those account managers have very few accounts. They're assigned a very select number. That one's kind of a support question. How many people are in each level? Yeah, that's a good question. I saw the last chart that we had before we pushed this live. It's pretty equitable, believe it or not. So Access Now, obviously we've got a lot of publishers, thousands in there. Same thing with level one. And then two, three, four, and VIP. It's actually pretty even. A couple thousand for each of those. And then it sort of is very heavily weighted Access Now level one, and then quite a few level two through VIP. Someone asking, will the additional ad partners and things like that be added automatically? Yeah, it's automatic. There may be some sort of delay. That's one of the reasons why we want to show in the dashboard eventually which partners and things like that have been potentially added, because it may be a situation where, you know, 8 get added, you know, as soon as you're into the level, and then, you know, one more we have to wait on or something like that, and eventually it gets added. So, but yeah, I think you'll start to see it in revenue and things along those lines as you move throughout different levels. Any hint for tomorrow's drop? Boy, let's see. Tomorrow's is really about our technology and about giving our publishers help that they used to pay for and giving it to them for free. So that's tomorrow. And then a hint for Wednesday is, if you like WordPress and you'd like things with Ezoic to be easier, I've got good news. So I'll leave it at that. And I've actually hit the bottom of the Q&A. Before I give everyone a chance to start populating with even more, I'm going to just call it a day. And I look forward to talking to all of you later this week. And hopefully this has been helpful. And yeah, thanks for joining. And hopefully I'll see you sometime soon.